Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, StraightSmileSolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about selecting which incisor to extract if you need a lower incisor extraction case. And if you want to learn more about lower incisor extractions versus IPR versus distalization, you can go into my YouTube channel, not YouTube in general, but my YouTube channel, Straight Smile Solutions. Once you're within that channel, there should be a green banner at the top. You go to the small magnified glass. There's a little tiny little magnifying glass, just a few millimeters in the kind of the top right area. Click on that, put in your keyword. So you can put in IPR or lower incisor extraction, and all the videos and content that I've made on that will pop up. But specifically the question today is, how do you select which incisor to extract? And there's no right or wrong answer to this. I mean, first thing I look at, I mean, for the most part, to be honest, let's say hypothetically I'm the orthodontist and the patient has a general dentist, I often defer to the general dentist if I'm not sure. Let them pick. So obviously we wanna pick the tooth with the worst prognosis. If there's a tooth that has a filling or a root canal or has wear or has root resorption or has some perio, that's going to be our first choice, right? Because we can always move around the teeth. It's not a big deal. You're already not going to have a midline if you take out a lower incisor. So if the patient is young, let's say they're 20, 21, 22, and we have none of that, then, you know, if it's all the same and we got four teeth to choose from, the other thing you're going to think about is size. Usually the centrals, the ones 24 and 25, are slightly smaller than the laterals 23 and 26, the lower twos. Not always, but usually. So often I don't need as much space. So then, of course, I'd pick a central over a lateral. If I needed more space, I'd pick a lateral over a central because usually I get another millimeter out of it. Just a friendly reminder, why do we take out lower incisors? Well, normally I take out lower incisors if the patient is edge to edge or slight class three, or if the patient has like crazy perio and I don't want to flare teeth forward and they have lower crowding and they're okay with having a little overjet, then I'll do that instead of a ton of IPR. Because remember, here's the ways that you can correct crowding, and we can go over this again, because once you kind of get it in your head, then you'll remember, right? Ways we can correct crowding. Well, I mean, in a healthy patient, you know, age 20, no perio, lots of good bone, lots of good roots, then your options are arch expansion, proclination, distalization, scooting teeth back, IPR, and extractions. Those are your five options, right? In an older patient, some of those options are not available. Your arch expansion may not be available. You know, you can expand with wires, you can expand with appliances. Proclination is probably not available because you're going to push the teeth out the bone or they're going to get loose. So you're more likely in an older patient or a perio patient to take out a lower incisor, unless the patient, like I said, is class three, and then you do a lower incisor. So there are some straightwire companies / bracketing, I'm not going to mention who they are, that take out lower incisors, I think, way more aggressively than they need to. It's super not needed just because it's fast and easy. Okay. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. You just want to make sure in those situations that you're explaining the risks, benefits, and alternatives to the patient so they understand what their options are and they can choose between maybe having some distalization. Of course, to do distalization, you have to make sure there's no impacted molars, right? Or no erupted third molars, or you're not going to have space to do it. They could do arch expansion. They could do lots of other things. They could do IPR, which sometimes can take a little bit longer. The lower incisor extraction is quick, dirty, and easy. So anyways, to answer your question, lots of things to take into account. You know, if everything is all the same, the teeth are all the same size, we have no perio, no attrition, no endo, no restorations, no root resorption, you know, et cetera, then I'm going to pick the one that's most displaced, you know? So for example, on this one, I'd probably take that one out. On this one, I'd probably take the most buccal one out or the most lingual one out, either way. Or probably this one, because this one's rotated in, this one's like that, right? So usually the most buccal one has the most recession. So makes it easier for me to align the teeth. But anyways, that's how you pick. It's pretty much it. So if you're an orthodontist, generally we consult with the general dentist. If we have any questions, you know, otherwise if the general dentist has no opinion, then we're going to pick out the one that makes our life easier. All right. Thanks so much.